Hi everyone, in this video we are going to go over the topic of parameters in Power BI. Parameters for some reason in Power BI are not as intuitive as you might expect, so hopefully by the end of this video you'll have a better understanding of how they work and how you can use them on your dashboards. I'm assuming that you're familiar with the concept of a parameter. Usually you'll pass this into a query to filter your data set or do some other custom logic with it. If you remember, in previous videos, we talked about filters, and oftentimes these two can get switched up or confused. And the way I like to think about it is a filter is something that happens after a data set has already been returned, whereas a parameter is actually limiting your data set before it gets to you. So again, a filter, the data set has already been returned, and you're just filtering on what has been returned. Whereas a parameter is actually dictating what gets returned in that data set to begin with. There are two ways you can go about adding parameters to your report. And the first one we'll look at is on your main page here. To add a parameter this way, it's actually pretty straightforward. Go over to the modeling tab here and just select new parameter. And here you'll get some basic options. You'll get name, data type. It'll ask you for a minimum value, a maximum value, as well as how you want it to increment. So do you want it to go from 0 to 20 by 1, 2, 3, 5, whatever, and a default value. It also gives you the option to add this parameter as a slicer to your page if you want to. Power BI understands that oftentimes that's how your users are going to want to interact with it. It should be something that's easy to work with. So you have this option to add it if you want, and we will add it just to show you how that works. And let's give this a name and click OK. Now we can see it got added here, the bottom left on our current page. So let's move this up here. And if we move this here, we can see this value is changing. And another thing to point out here, if we look at fields, we can see this was actually added as a new data set, price parameter. And there's two options. We have the price parameter value here second, and then the name of it. I've selected this, and you can see up here in the formula bar, it essentially just creates a little DAX query for you to create this parameter. And in this case, we're just generating a series 0 to 20, incrementing by 1. To show you what this one means here, I'm going to add a card, and the field on the card will be the value of the parameter. And here we can see it's going to reflect what we have here. Put them next to each other so it's easier. This is based on the name, and this is based on the value. So you can use them interchangeably to make it a little easier for your users to see what's going on. But currently, nothing's actually happening with this parameter. We're not using it to do anything. It's just, you know, displaying a value to us. So how would we use it? What we could do here is just create a brand new measure that will give us some sort of value based on the parameter. So it's almost like you're inserting it into a query. But in this case, we'll use it in a DAX function. Within internet sales here, I'm going to select new measure. Seeing that we have an order quantity column here, this is just summing the order quantity value. What we could do here is create a similar measure, but instituting this parameter within it. I've just copied this DAX query in here for the sake of time. And essentially what this is doing is first filtering the internet sales model that we have here. And it's going to sum up the order quantity, just like we do here. But now that we're using this filter function here, we need to give it something to filter by. And what we could do here is use the parameter. So to do that, if I start typing out parameter, it's going to recognize the name of this. We called it price parameter. And it's selectable in your DAX query. So we can put this in here. Now, right now, we're getting no values because we're saying where the price is less than the parameter. So there are no bikes. And because we're filtered on bikes, there are no bikes less than $20. Let's unfilter, and now we can see we're getting some values because while this one is looking at everything, this is using that parameter to filter it. Only look at results where that filter is true, and that filter is based on our parameter. And that's one way to use a parameter in a DAX query and make it visible for users as well. But let's actually add something that would filter the actual data set itself. And how would you do that? Let's go through and edit queries. Now, right off the bat here, we can see there's an option here for manage parameters. And let's select new parameter. and we can add a new name. And you'll see this is new. This is not the same as what we just worked with. This is going to filter the actual data before it ever comes into your models itself. It will be added as a transform step over here. Let's call this one color. Here, there are many more options. We'll say this is a text. There are three options for the suggested values, and we'll go through all three. First is any value, meaning you could just insert whatever you want. A list of values, you'll be able to actually give a hard-coded list right here in Power BI. And then a query is going to be based on some other file or SQL statement that you return, essentially some other data set. So start, we'll do any value, and let's just say black. Select OK. Now we can see this came up here as another query over here just for color. This is where it's going to hold that parameter. And to use it, let's go to product. We select filter. Let's just say equals. And here, just you could hard code something in here and say whatever you want. But the other option here is to filter by a parameter. And now we could have added it new from here, but let's say parameter. And we only have one option, but this is where you can use that as well. Let's select OK. And now this whole data set is filtered by just color. And again, it's similar to a filter that you would do, you know, on this over here. But instead, we're actually filtering the data before it ever gets there. So this would apply as a transform before it ever gets to your report to even be filtered. Now let's add a new one. Let's do a list. We'll call this one first name. We'll go again with text. In this case, we'll say list of values, and we can put John, Michael, Jennifer. Hopefully these are options. And Lisa. Default, it now recognizes that this is a list, so your default value is pulling from that list. And a current value, same thing, you select from the list. Select OK, and let's see if we can use that over here. Equals parameter, and this time we'll click first name. And because our first name is set the current value of Michael, all these will filter to Michael. And if we were to change this here to Lisa, now these are filtered to Lisa. Now the last option is to create a parameter based on a query. And how would we do this? It has to be based on a list. You could either do a select statement that could be one of your queries here. It could be an uploaded file, whatever you want. And in this example, I'm just going to upload this comma separated list that I put together. So let's new query and add this test list, and it will recognize what this is. Not too concerned about the formatting for now. Let's just say okay. And what we need to do in order for this to work, and this is important because if you have any sort of data set here that you want to use for this purpose, what you have to do is make sure that it's formatted as a list. And to do that, we will go to transform with this selected and say convert to list. And now this will put it in a single column as a list, and we can use this. Now let's hop back to customer and I'll show you how this works. If we go to occupation, just like the other ones, we'll do a filter equals, and this time we'll do a new parameter and call this occupation type text, and this will be a query. Now we have this option here, test list, because of what we just did. Current value, I'll say management. Okay. Now what we'll do is close and apply. We have those three parameters. It's refiltering our data set, and we're only getting back now results that met that criteria. To make this a little more clear, I've added in the customer name here to this list so we can see a little more clearly what's actually happening. And I'll filter it down to where it's not blank. When we change this now, we can actually see what's going on. Let's apply these changes. Now we're only getting Michael. And this is all because the underlying data set is now only returning where that's true. Change this to black. And there's only this. So we went through two different ways to add parameters. One is just adding something right on the page itself. The second option we looked at was using a parameter within your queries, which would then limit the data that was returned, and then showing how you would edit those, which would be using this edit parameters task here. It's definitely not as intuitive to edit these parameters as it is to just change filters, so that's something to consider, especially if your users aren't as comfortable working up here and changing it and knowing where to look, whereas filters can be a little easier. But this is how you would do it in Power BI. Thank you for watching. If you found this helpful, please feel free to like the video, leave a comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you at the next video. Thank you.